Fam, what's up? It's your boy T the Barber. Make sure y'all checking me out on all social media networks. Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. A lot of good work for y'all. Y'all stay tuned and make sure you subscribe. Yo, YouTube, what's up? It's your boy T the Barber. Got something different for you guys today. We're gonna be doing a light fade, you know, with the taper at the bottom. Stay tuned, make sure you subscribe, like, comment, all that good stuff. And check me out on tthebarber.com. Alright guys, today's tools we're gonna be using. The Super ZR by Andy's, brand new, very strong. The Andy's Master is what we're gonna be blending with. We got both of the Slimline Pros today. We got the Andy's number 1, 2, 3, 4. We got the Speedo Guide number 2 and number 1. A lot of people keep asking me in the comments, why do I use 2 number 1s or 2 number 2s? So I'm gonna show y'all. These guards are not the same size. The Andy's 2 is a little bit bigger than the Speedo Guide 2. So this was, I'm gonna use this more like a 1.5, and this is gonna be like a 2-2. And the same thing with the number 1. The Andy's number 1 is just a tad bit bigger. So this is like my half blade, and this is gonna be like my 1. Alright y'all, let's get right into it. Alright guys, remember, first things first, always make sure the hair is clean before you cut it. And before you get started, always comb through the hair. Just get everything in position before we get started. Alright guys, I'm using the 000 blade on the Supra. These are detachable blades that you can put on these clippers. They come right off and go right on. This particular blade here is compatible to just the closed level on the Andy's Master. Since we're doing a light fade, I'm gonna use the Speedo Guide number 2 on the sides, and we're gonna work our way up to the number 4 on top. All right guys, we're gonna come to about right here with the number 2, the Speedo Guide number 2, and we're gonna go all the way around, just above the ear here. Alright guys, notice that this is the line that we're following here, and the closer I get to it, I start to bump up. Instead of just making this line all the way across, if you start bumping up here, as you're making your guideline, it's going to be easier for you to blend in the end. When you're cutting straight hair, you want to make sure you're constantly keeping your work area clean, a lot of brushing, you know, just to make sure that you got all the hair that's been cut out of the way. I'm noticing here it's a little darker in these areas, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow the growth pattern here and just kind of slant up with the number 2 here and the opposite way here to make sure that all is even. When you're cutting straight hair, sometimes that happens. So you just have to make sure you're following the opposite direction of the growth pattern. Next up, We're gonna play with this line here, taking the number 3 and the Andy's Master all the way close. We're just gonna bump all the way up around here. Alright guys, next step, I'm going back with the Andy's Master again. Number 2, label it 0. And I'm going to come here and I'm going to take this line out that you guys see here on the bottom. By doing so, I'm just going to bump here with the 2. Between the 2, I'm going to be switching from the 2 close to the 2 open, which is technically a 2.5. And you'll see me, you know, just judging by eye, coming from 0 to open, 0 to half, 0 to half, all the way around this first level on the bottom. Remember guys, make sure you're brushing when you're blending, you're constantly brushing to get all that loose hair out of there. Alright guys, next we're back with the Andy's Master and the number 3 Andy's Guard, and we're gonna just blend up a little bit higher with the 3.5. When I say 3.5, I mean the 3 guard on and the Masters all the way open. This is like a half blade here. When you see darker areas in the blend like here and here, you just want to make sure you go back in this case with the 3 closed, and that'll take all of that out of there. Now I'm going back with the Speedo Guide number 2, and I'm just going to clean it up some more right in this area. Now I'm going to take the number 4 on the Supra ZR here, and we're going to go full speed with that. This has 4 speeds, Got 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we're gonna use that number 4 to cut the top with. Okay, while you're cutting the top, in this case here, you'll see that it kind of has a swirl here in the front or a cavity. So I'm cutting with the number 4 against the grain. And in this case, you'll see me moving the clipper to the opposite side of that, you know, all over the head. And that's going to make sure that you get all the extra hairs that can stick up. Sometimes the clipper can miss them. No, but I just go against the grain in all directions when I'm cutting the top of straight hair. Alright guys, I'm back with the Andy's Master using the number 4 guard by Andy's. I know a lot of you guys ask, are my masters zero gap? No, they're not. These are not fade masters. These are the regular Andy's Master with the regular blade on them. And what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to clean up the top a little bit more with this clipper. Sometimes we have to switch. You know, I go back and forth between the ZR and the Master. This is because sometimes this clipper will pick up a little bit more than the ZR will. Now we're gonna go back with the number 3, and we're just gonna bump all the way around to make sure we got it nice and blended. Alright guys, one of the last steps, we're going to do a taper on the bottom, on the sides and the back. So I'm just going to come here using the zero and the half blade and just blend up here, and the same thing on the sides. And by when I say zero, I mean all the way closed on the master. And the half blade would be all the way open. Alright guys, number 1 guard, using it between 0 and half, and we're going to take this weight line here out Last but not least, take the half blade and cleaning this little area up here. I don't know, you know, it's just a tad bit of weight left here. So we're gonna take the half blade and get rid of that. One of the last steps, we're gonna taper or line up the neck, both sides going around the ear here, and the same thing here. Remember, I do my tapers last. So after we line this up, then we will go back in and blend this area here on both sides. Okay guys, on the lineup in the front, make sure you're following it as natural as possible. It's okay to alter it just a little bit, but you don't want to push it too far back. You know, there's always, 9 times out of 10, going to be some type of imperfection in the natural hairline, so it's okay to alter it just a little bit to give it that perfect look. Alright guys, last step, I'm going to come in here and just do a light taper on the bottom here on both sides and line them up with the razor, and it's a wrap. Very simple to blend taper on the sides. Since the sides were cut at a number 2, I'm going to go from 0 to half. Starting with the 0, bump it up, go to half, and clean it up a little bit more. Very simple. May only need the one guard, the number 1 guard, just to clean the area up right here just above the ear. When you're tapering it, it's always good to use the corners of the blade. That keeps you from taking the blend line up too high, and it also lets you go into the blend a little bit more detailed than just using the flat blade itself. one. I'm just gonna eliminate the weight that we have here with the number one using the corners of the blade. And it's done. The best razor on the market right now, Dorco Prime, is the only thing I'm using. Very sharp blade, and it really gives you a real nice clean up. Don't have to go over and over and over the same spot so many times like other razors. It's great stuff right here, y'all check them out. When you're lining up straight hair, Caucasian hair, Hispanic hair, when you're lining them up with the razor, always go against the grain because it's going to give you a closer shave, which is going to really bring out the edge up. On the hairline here, you see we have a couple of hairs hanging over. So I'm just gonna take my scissors and go across there and clean it up. Sometimes that happens with straight hair, but sometimes it doesn't. In this case, like I told you earlier, he has a swirl here, or some people call it a cowlick, and that's probably why we have so much overhang. So I'm just gonna take my scissors here and graze the hairline and get the extra hair that's hanging over. Alright YouTube, just gave you a light fade with a taper on the bottom, number 2 on the sides, number 4 on the top. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Check out the work we're bringing for y'all. A lot more stuff coming soon. Any suggestions, comments, like, subscribe, everything's appreciated.
Got that fresh cut from Tita Barber. Feel like $1 million. Check them out. Tita Barber. Like, comment. Be dope. Check them out.